certainly this past one from the studio supported by 2.9 FM. Good afternoon and welcome to this Friday's edition of Pains, Love and Family. My name is Dimeji Danes and Moni is here.
My yes, I'm here. Thank God it's Friday again.
So today, you know, oftentimes there are so many reasons for unhappy marriages. People argue from time to time. You have incessant argument, you have complaints and all of that. And oftentimes, if you look at the root of all of this, you find a lot of mismatches in some of these marriages where, take for instance, you have an intelligent person married to somebody who is not so intelligent, or a party-goer married to somebody who does not go in, who does not love going to parties, or you have an extrovert married to an introvert. And sometimes you have somebody who is highly organized and very neat, married to somebody who is highly disorganized and very untidy.
That part is the one that got me, because I know that in the present day marriage, in the sense of it, I mean, today's marriage, you know, you find that more among people because people now work, especially, you know, the woman works more now. The husband may go to work and the woman also goes to work, so she comes back bust like this as she's in the city, one leg is in the city,
and then the man comes back and sees all of that and doesn't love it. And beyond that, you also have cases of, you know, financial mismatch, sexual mismatch. Yeah. There are a lot of these things. That is what we'll be talking about on Pains, Love and Family this afternoon. We'll also be looking at probably if there are solutions, if such marriages are workable, if the only solution to it is for them to go their separate ways. So let's introduce our guest. We have
in the house expert Jumoke Watashabi. She got the name on Wednesday. She was branded relationship expert Jumoke Watashabi,
PLF ambassador.
Now from my heart. I got that from
No, you are still PLF ambassador. I'm not taking that away from
you. I declare they will miss us on the program.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
It's veteran, a beautiful afternoon.
Veteran married Adekule Adeumi.
Thank you.
And your farmer, broadcaster. Okay, let's welcome the expert in the house.
Yes.
Professor of psychology.
He's from the Department of Pure and Applied Psychology. Adekunle Ajashi University, Akumbakoko. That is Professor Bolanle Ogunbamila. Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much. I'm happy to be here.
Let's start from the expert.
Okay.
So, mismatches. What is your insight into that?
Well, mismatches are going to happen in marriages. I'm sorry to start on that note. But the level and the extent is what gives us a lot of concern. The two individuals are not from the same family.
Not the same background.
In most cases, not from the same culture, and sometimes not from the same country. So even identical twins that are from the same zygote, they have different psychological makeups. But in most cases, we get deceived by their physical semblance. And sometimes to deceive us the more, they wear the same clothes. So talk less of an individual who is married to another person who is not from his culture, from his religious background, from his country, and so on and so forth. Definitely there will be some differences.
Now, like you said, but it depends on the extent. I read a lot of materials about this as well. Where, for instance, you have somebody who is, like I said at the beginning of the program, very organized and very neat on, say, 80%, and then you have somebody who is on 10%, 80 to 20%. That's huge.
Yeah.
That's huge.
Yeah.
Now, how do you deal with that?
Well, the first thing is to break down the marriage into its important components. What do I mean by that? What are those things that people normally cherish in marriage and in their partners? we have to look at those issues, those points one after the other.
Okay.
And then if that particular aspect seems to be the most salient one that that particular partner cherishes, then we could have a huge problem.
Okay.
If we don't know, if we cannot teach, or if the partner cannot get the other partner,
can I adjust to the difference
to that particular
thing. But is it possible to know or get some of this, the frequency, you know, like major?
It is.
Is it possible to get it before marriage so that you don't even bother going into the marriage in the first place?
It is possible, but sometimes extremely difficult.
Why? Love?
What?
It's not love. Sorry, Professor, to cut in. Let me give you an testimony. Like I said, you have somebody who is very neat and very tidy outside of the house. There are people like that.
Outside of the house?
Yes. I lived with a friend like that when I was in the university. My friend, handsome, very clean, very neat, very proper, prim and proper. And then it comes into our room. His trousers is on the chair. His necklace is under the mattress, and then his boxers is
on the
and then he walks in on the rug, carpet, with his shoes, with his daddy shoes. So to the extent that it becomes very difficult for me, you know, because I love, you know, sweep, and even his girlfriend was complaining. So you have people like that. So if you do not, if you're dating somebody like that, and you do not go to their home, you don't see them in their relaxed environment, like you said, Oturaka. Mm. You would not know. You think, oh, Moni is very neat, because you only see Moni at work. What about Moni at home?
Yeah.
Okay.
So that is what we normally refer to as situational specificity in behavior. Your behavior, to a large extent, is determined by the situation you find yourself and the situation you cherish. That is why people can be in the church and appear very gentle, very humble, very meek. Immediately they leave the church, they are
there is a fight.
Yeah.
They kneel down for the pastors, and then at home they don't. Okay.
Yeah, Jim, okay. I know that. Okay, don't let me turn to the veteran.
What do you hold me
no,
about,
no,
veteran?
You're going to be 10 years in marriage, or you're already 10 years in marriage. No, Nasa.
I will reserve my comment on that.
No,
that's your question.
Close your question because of our time.
That's why I'm actually asking my question.
Okay,
because
okay.
I've heard people, especially, I remember last week, myself and Jumoke were talking about people who decide to, people who decide to stay together or live together so they can know themselves. You know, so because of that, they do cohabitation, they stay in the house to know themselves. And then we're trying to raise a point that you can't know your partner by living together before marriage.
Yes.
You know, so I know you've lived with your wife at least 9 years.
Okay.
So now,
have you seen any mismatches?
Yeah. Can you point out some of the mismatches that you are
cooking? That give you concern?
Yeah.
yes, a lot.
A lot?
Yes.
Okay. There are always a lot.
Only if you want to shy away from them.
Okay.
A lot. Like where I come from now, like if I have a phone with me now you ask, phone do allow in she techno ni rara infinix ni.
I don't get like
sarcasm.
Yes. Okay. So my wife doesn't like that.
Okay.
And to me, where I'm coming from, it's just a joke. So part of it.
It's a mismatch.
Yes.
Okay.
Is that. That's a typical
well, that
example.
Well, we'll work at it. Go right inside of this machine.
So I got to know that she doesn't like it.
Okay.
Just call a spade a spade.
For
so
her.
So yes, you can overcome that by conquering your own selfishness. Your own you can make that sacrifice for your partner. So you can actually overcome your own part of the. I don't
the comedy.
Know.
Yeah.
No, this is not comedy. I'm just citing that as an example.
Yeah.
So you can actually adjust. That one you can adjust.
Yeah.
So you don't have to keep repeating it when you know this thing hurts
well
this person. Since it is something that you can adjust, I believe you should be able
to
adjust.
Is there anyone you think you can't adjust to?
From the mismatches? I can't remember. The one I have with my wife, no.
Yes.
No.
Oh, okay.
No. That seems... Let me pose another question to you, Kule. Okay. That one seems simple.
Okay.
What about a situation where you have... it gets to a point that it could be affecting the other person.
Yeah.
Yes.
It could be affecting the other person negatively.
Yes.
Their mental wellness.
Yes.
Let's say, for instance, you are the kind of person who cherishes absolute truth, honesty.
Yes.
And then you have somebody who is morally flexible, who does not see it as a big D. Mm-hmm. A big D. You know, women say that. Yes. When you see women sit and talk among themselves, and then you're married to a husband who cherishes honesty, truth. 100%.
Yes.
And then you keep doing that. You keep doing that. You keep living like that. And the person keeps telling you,
I don't like this.
I don't like this because it affects the person. Mm. It's like they are, it is like what makes them flare up.
Mm.
And at every point, the person catches you in a lie, it flares up.
Yes.
How do you do that?
That's what I'm trying to say. You can still control that as well.
That depends on the partner
The person who lies. Okay.
Should be the person to adjust change. In this situation.
Yeah.
Because when you call something marriage,
if the person does not adjust, then what happens?
It can't work. The family cannot work out. If you lie today, I catch you. Lie tomorrow, I catch you.
Kilo Marshall, let's not talk.
Well, several things can happen.
Hmm. Okay.
When there is a lot of tension in the marriage, the partner, the affected partner, I will use the word victim now, may cry a lot.
Even if the partner is a man.
The man can cry.
Sometimes he cries inwardly. You may not see the tears.
He may not be able to concentrate at work. Mm-hmm. Even at home, he may not be able to concentrate. He may isolate himself. He may eat less. He may eat more. He may have difficulty in initiating sleep and enjoying quality sleep.
And it may reduce the love or affection he has for you.
Definitely, it will.
You may start thinking of options.
Yeah.
Alternatives to that person. He may also turn to drugs, substance abuse, alcoholism, staying out.
Could I be responsible for why some men stay out late?
Yes, just to avoid the situation. But when those behavioral responses become a little more frequent and the victim or the partner continues to exhibit that kind of behavior that the person does not like, then it signals the red flags.
Hmm.
One, the person that is adversely affected yells. You know, it's different from just talking at a very
high shout.
Yes.
Yelling.
That is even more serious than shouting.
Yeah, he's more serious. He shouts. He gets angry easily. Mm. He's irritated. Mm. He could become depressed if the person feels that I don't have as much power as my partner. He becomes depressed. Suicide may come in. Suicidal ideation.
For real?
The person may think of quitting the marriage. That is, avoiding the situation altogether. Then he may not want to be in close contact with those who are related to that particular person. It is becoming a huge problem at that level. He's avoiding the family, he's avoiding
the in-laws.
The in-laws, the relatives, avoiding the home, which is the point of the exhibition of those
traits.
Stress.
But I think that before they get to that level, what happens to having a conversation? I mean, the person...
Before it gets to that level, that means conversation has failed.
Yes.
Yeah. Some other
you see, before it gets to Yeni, it must have talked to the person.
Yeah.
It must have... It's not every couple that have... they don't sit to... It's not money, every couple that sit to talk.
Money, before it gets to the point where couples don't sit to talk, they must have talked.
Yes.
Yeah. I know. They must have talked. It must have appealed.
Yes.
It must have begged.
Forms of communication.
Yes. It must have even. Yes. Wait, wait. It must have even talked to people to help talk to the spouse.
Yeah. Okay.
And then it gets to a point where it sees that just talking is not working. Then it gravitates towards shouting, complaining, being irritated. But I told you, I don't like this.
Yeah.
The voice is becoming louder. Then it gets to the point of yelling. For instance, I don't know if you remember when we had Zadok's wife on this program. She said something. She said, our husband hardly eats. She knows that. But there's something the husband does not like, that Zadok does not like. That Zadok does not like coming home to a dirty house. So she knows that. When the husband is out of the house, she ensures that everything is well arranged. Well, everything is neat, everything is clean. So even if you don't give him food, as long as he comes home to a clean house, he's happy. So if you were the wife of that, now she was saying that because she understands some women
would not.
Those are the women where, you know, they will tell you, ah, maybe it's junior diet on the dining table now. They are your kicks. They, you know, you find the spoon on the sitting room, living room chairs. You find the everywhere is just.
But even in that circumstance, Dimeji, I think there should also be room for some little, how do I call it now? In situation where it doesn't happen. I know she will be trying in the situation of the Zadok, which you mentioned. I think there will be situations where it may not be. But he knows that she's trying to yield to what he likes.
She says. Every time he's out of the house, she ensures the house is clean.
Yes, that's part of the
and that the man appreciates that. Mm-hmm. And that when he sees that, he tries to help out. But if he comes home and the house, he would not even think. Oh, okay. For instance, you are married to somebody who likes a clean house, and then he stops complaining. He wakes up very early in the morning
to be cleaning the house himself.
To start cleaning the house himself. Mop everywhere.
He doesn't need to tell you that.
From there, he moves to the kitchen, cleans the kitchen. he does the bedspread and all of that. And then 30 minutes later, you, the wife.
I want to scatter it.
That's trouble.
Jim, okay. Let's turn to you. Tell us some of these mismatches that you've noticed.
Well, for me personally, well, let me use myself as.
And there ones you've seen your husband that you do not like.
Of course,
a lot of them.
Are they working up?
Of course, that's why they're still together.
They're working it out. Of course, that's the word. We are working it out. You know, maybe where I was born and where I grew up from, our lifestyle is not. It's
you're
not
conservative.
The same.
You're conservative. I am. You're northern people. Mm-hmm.
So, you know. When I decided to get married to him, I remember one of my aunts was like, "Ha, she show up my life, baby, job, baby, papa, bye." Ah, to this one, come on, come on, come on, want to and he tell the one baby, bye. Let me church, get para, see, get no. You know, when my auntie said that, I was trying to like, there's no harm in moving out of where you used to be. You know, so after getting married, my husband was trying to like. Blend to my lifestyle. He's this type of person that likes to be out, but me, I prefer that when I go out, that time I should be home. So when the first year of our marriage was
very difficult,
I was like, am I sure I can stay till this time? Because when he comes home, I'm not the kind of talking person. I withdraw. I serve him his food, go back to the room
to sleep because you were pissed off.
I was angry, so he took him time to like I'm not sure I can understand this thing, but later on I discovered that this is him. You know, the only thing now he was not able to do was to reduce the number of hours.
Yeah,
he stays out.
Find a compromise.
So when his friends are even like, "How we say, Aji Awale," so people are not like, "Ah, we like where you are," you know. And I could remember before we got married. He would say, "I'm going to club." I was like,
Club.
Give me that. So a day before, I think after our introduction, so I came around and I said, he's going to club. I should come. Funny enough, I don't even have a trouser. I don't have one. So I said, I was scared. He said, ah, that I was scared. Though. You know, so, we just find a way. I got one. And when I got it, I sat down. I was looking. I said, what man did they do? I said, eh? This way that they are smoking, drinking. So many things like that, that I don't have a choice than for me to bend and for him to.
Are there ones that could get as serious as affecting your mental well-being or your health? Thinking about it?
Yes. He I don't
that know. Gets if, you, if that gets you, that gets you depressed.
If he's listening now, I'm this kind of person, I don't like you saying too long on phone.
Okay.
Let's talk.
Not okay, if he's with another person on the phone.
Yes, I don't like
it. Okay. Male or female? I don't talking business.
I know he's not talking business.
All women.
Jim, okay?
All women.
It's not all women.
Personally, I don't like it.
Okay.
Even, you know, it got to a time the children were like, who is bad? Daddy always talking to.
The nature of his job, perhaps.
So, and I told him, I said, is there no way you can? You know, that he knows when I say, sir, he would tell me, sir, Abosini. He knows he's a lie. Say, sir, he say, where? He say, he might not be doing anything on the phone, but when he comes in, I expect that, okay, when we'll sit, talk, watch TV.
In wee time, yeah.
So, he went out, my thing was, sir, all these kids that came out that day, he would sit down and watch everything. I was like, give me, whoa. You know, the children were now complaining. So, it got to a time, if he's doing that, and the children are like, dad, and that he will turn and look and say, as he pass your minutes, you know, he will adjust. So I think gradually we are coming out.
Okay, let's turn to the professor. What happens, like I asked Jim, okay, when it gets to a point that it affects the other person's mental well-being and there seems to be no solution in sight?
Can I add to that question?
Yes, please do.
I think my question should come first before he.
Okay.
What are those mismatches that you think could affect the psychological well-being of either of the partner?
Well, the ones that are very strong will have to do with the personality characteristics of those persons. And then what they value in life. Your value is what sort of person you want to be. Do I want to be a caring father? Or a caring wife? And if the behaviors of your partner are adversely affecting that thing that you value, preventing you from
being what you want to be,
is going to affect your mental well-being.
Let me paint this scenario. When you have somebody who is always on the go, it could be the woman, it could be the man, on the go-getter, and very ambitious, and you have somebody, a spouse, the other spouse, who loves the status quo. Life, you, dear little, yeah. Well, be a struggle, you struggle, alone, power man. And so you have somebody who has lofty dreams, of where they want to be, where they want to go in future, and then you have a wife or a husband, if you ask him or her, where do you see yourself in 5 years?
Shouldn't you know that before you even settle down with such a person?
People
it's not possible.
You may not. There are people who show that they are, there are even people whose only ambition is that marriage. So girls get married and get settled, and they will do everything
to keep that,
to make sure that they get married. Mm-hmm. And when they get married, they relax because their best dream in life has been achieved, and then so
okay,
no more dreaming.
So to my questions, Professor,
the level at which it affects the mental well-being of the person depends on the power balance between the partners. I will explain. Power balance may have to do with the person who has the highest or the higher influence in terms of economic, in terms of religious, in terms of interpersonal, and so on and so forth. For example, if you are somebody who is a go-getter, you want something higher than what you have now, and your wife is the one who has the economic power,
and that's
she's
serious.
Not supporting you. How do you get that? One, you are going to form an impression that she never liked what you want to be. and you may start thinking of alternative if you cannot make us see reasons with you. And the more you look for alternatives,
the farther you go from each other.
You drift away
from each other,
from your partner.
Okay, what happens when the villain plays the victim? For instance, you mentioned something. It gets to a point where the other person is now yelling. Maybe it's the woman who yells.
Yeah.
And the neighbor say, woman with the edutti. Let me use that word. Let me correct myself. Well, I have edutti berekine, utiti kine edutti desi, kotie wulo, kotie niwa. And the villain, the villain's voice is never heard.
Yeah.
Is the one who is playing the victim.
Yes.
Share me by. And so women do that too.
Yeah.
They are the cause of the problem.
They pretend.
Oh, fiya je woman ye.
That's why I said it is always very difficult to get all the points that you desire to know before you get married. Because a lot of people will pretend. The circumstance before the marriage may not really bring out that behavior you have.
Yes, yes.
It is right. When the tension of marriage
comes in.
The wahala, I'm sorry to use the word, of raising kids, meeting demands of families and friends and so on and so forth. When the pressure comes in, that is when the behavior of that man, of that woman will come on top.
Now, those are personality traits. Now, what happens when you have financial mismatch, where one person seems like the sole provider, the other person does not even care, is not making efforts to step up his or her game, and then the other aspect of it, sexual mismatch, somebody has a high libido, the other person has a very low libido. My pastor was telling me about a woman who came to him and was complaining. What do you do?
You didn't finish the story now.
We are on air, Moni. You should understand.
Is she taking too much or less?
She doesn't want
this. It was too much for her.
Okay.
Yeah. Now, when you have situations like that, what do you do?
When we have such situations, the first thing is we may seek expert advice.
Okay.
We seek expert advice, and then we break down the marriage into components. You have to break down the marriage to components.
How do you do that?
There are important components of marriage. Sex is one of them. Humility is one of them. Faithfulness.
It's one of them.
Selflessness. And so many other ones.
What about compromise?
Yes. Part of it. I said so many other ones.
Okay.
Then including communication. So if one aspect of the person's life is not bringing enough comfort, but other aspects are bringing more than enough comfort, the marriage will still survive.
Okay.
So we, as experts, what we do is to help the person to break the marriage into components.
To know what really matters.
What are the important things that can be used to overshadow the other one. Then, in such a case, we also bring in the partner at a point. In one of the programs that I heard recently, somebody asked this type of question that, suppose a man is demanding too much and so on. I said the easiest way is for the man to take cold water when the urge is high.
Okay, that works?
Yeah.
It works?
It will go down.
Okay. What if he does not like cold water? What if he does not like cold water?
Exactly, a broadcaster.
What if he does not like cold water? He has a program. Okay, broadcaster.
Yes.
Who has a program the following Monday? Oju Mayo.
Yes.
5:50 a.m. the following day.
On Monday from morning to
5.
So it will not come around that time.
You 5:50 a.m.
By the time the urge.
And then he needs his voice.
exemptions.
The other one is to distract yourself.
Okay.
Why shouldn't it be all the time?
For some people, it's all the time. I know people like that.
The level of the sex hormone.
Yeah, in their body, yeah.
They're
different. Mm-hmm. Some people are ready to go. They're good to go 24/7.
As age increases, it dips.
It goes down, yeah.
So women's own dips faster than that of men.
Okay. Anything medically to correct that?
Huh? Yes. But I won't advise.
I think it has side effects.
It has a lot of side effects. People will take a lot of drugs and so on. I don't want to recommend that. So.
Okay, 17 minutes before 2 is Pains, Love and Family. We're talking about mismatches that create red flags in marriages. Let's have another musical break now. This one is from Casting Crowns and it's called Broken Together.
Okay, welcome back from that break. It's about 14 minutes before 2 from the studios of Adabaiti Banana FM. If you're just joining us, you missed a big part of the show, but don't worry, we still have something on our plates for you. So, Dimeji, you were talking about.
Okay, I saw something online, and it says, you know, talking about you can identify your own red flags. Let me read it. During interaction between the two of you, be on the outlook for times when, in the context of the relationship, you feel irritated, upset, confused, or distressed. The emotions provide clues to some red flags. You understand? Do you understand that, Professor?
Yes, I do.
Can you relate to that?
Yes. There are signs that one may need to look out for. But Matthew, it may not be ultimate.
Okay.
Because sometimes the partner may also try at that point in time to study you by deliberately doing those things
you don't like.
So they mask their own.
Yes. To see whether you are somebody who will be able to take in shock.
And somebody who likes going to parties pretending not to like parties at the time you were dating.
That is the issue.
And then you marry her, she's every week she's oh ambe. Ah, Niki party call Oshogo. Ah, I'm a David Ishao. Oshogo and long week. And they look on next week.
That is why I said sometimes what you know about the person before marriage may not be enough to help you go through
the marriage
and maintain it.
You just wake up one day and it seems you are married to a stranger, somebody you never knew.
It happens.
Because what he is experiencing at work, at some other places, may not be the same thing that you are experiencing. I may not want to tell you about it. He may feel that I don't want to bog down my partner with all this.
Or people who try to tell, like I was saying when we're off air, we had our break. Somebody who is highly logical, with somebody who is emotional.
Yeah.
The logical person, if he's trying to strike up a conversation with you, you have to watch out your responses. He's talking this, you're talking another thing. So the next time he's going to keep to himself.
That's the
issue. Money, let's take calls.
Okay. 0816251999 0816251999 Hello, good afternoon. Hello? Hello? 0816251999 That's the number to call. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
This is Elizabeth calling from Akure.
I didn't get your name.
This is Elizabeth.
Elizabeth. Elizabeth. Thank you very much for calling. Please go ahead.
God will bless those group in the studio this afternoon.
Amen.
You see, marriage, like Professor said, is all about adjustment. Just have to adjust. And let me use myself as an example. When I was coupling with my husband, I think it was just less than 3 years before we got married, I came to visit. And I discovered he's a cotton type. You see cloth everywhere, you see things everywhere. So I was trying to correct him, he was not taking to it. But when I got married, he continued. So it was not new to me. I adjusted. And as for me, I don't spend any money anyhow. I don't keep money. So he knew I love to spend money. If I go to the market, I'll even come back and take more. So when he wants to give me money, he will divide it into two. He will give the first part because I will definitely come back to take the second part. And he will now give me the second part. Yeah, so see, it's just all about adjustment. I have a twin sister. We have very, very opposite. I am Julia, she's not Julia. I love to give, she doesn't give. And we are still good to go. Close 37 years now. We are still good to go. So if we live in the same room for 9 months and we grew up from the same mother for years and she couldn't change, then you might not change your partner. Just try to adjust. You are just in sex. If you love being it every day, the man doesn't like it, just try to calm down. And I will round up by saying, if you look at the alphabet that starts marriage, it is letter M. The right one is bending for the left one. That's why the M can stand still. So if the man fails to bend and the woman fails to bend, the marriage will not work. God will bless your home in Jesus' name.
Amen. Thank you. That's very deep. The letter M. She was talking about the letter M. The way it's written. The revelation in deep. Let's take another call. 0816251999 Hi, good afternoon.
Hello, good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Who is speaking with us?
My name is Sonny from Fruta.
Thank you for calling. Please go ahead.
Hello.
Go ahead, please. We can hear you.
Hello.
We can hear you. Yeah, I think he can't hear us. Let's take another call. Hello, good afternoon. Hello. Hello, good afternoon.
Hello, good afternoon.
Yes, good afternoon.
I am Reverend George, calling from Ore.
Thank you for calling. Please go ahead.
Yeah, each and every one of you has spoken very well.
Thank you.
But the issue here is this. Marriage has no formula. No any particular formula. It cannot be stipulated that it should work this way. It is not science. It is just a case of trial and error. But I believe if one could have the courage to go in and along the line have the determination to make it work out, God may see to it and both of them will prevail. Thank you.
Thank you, Reverend. 0816251999 Hello, good afternoon. Okay. Hello. All right. The number again is 0816251999 Hello, good afternoon.
Hello, good afternoon.
Yes, good afternoon. What's the name, please? Please, can you put up your voice a little bit?
Hello.
Please increase the volume of your voice. Okay, let's try to take another call. Hello.
Hello.
Hi, good afternoon.
Yeah, God bless you. Afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Yeah, this is Mr. Dixon from ADIE.
Thank you for calling, Mr. Dixon.
God bless you, my sister.
Amen.
You see, this issue you have been discussing since, I love it so much. If everybody had the interest of listening to what I've been discussing ever since, it's a kind of experience someone should be undergone. If you are a married person, ordinarily marriage is not just a thing that God has interest upon. But depends on the individual, how you toss into your family's house. There are three categories of a marriage, or rather, the experience that we're passing through, rather, when you have a marriage issue. The first one, that if you marry a lady, there are a lot of problems with that, with the immunitating. To the other one again, if you are fortunate to have a child by then, there are another problem again, immunitating. Then the other one again, after having a child again, that's a big problem. If God be by your side, you'll be able to overcome it. But it is not having a kind of, maybe a perimeter, maybe a formula for you to undergo. But God, for God be the glory, you will pass through constant, perfect, constant perseverance and endurance.
Okay, because of our time, we'll not be able to take more of that call. But we'll take more calls at 0816-251-9991. Let's hear what you think about what we've been talking about.
Hello, good afternoon.
Afternoon.
Good afternoon. Who is speaking with us?
Simon.
Thank you for calling. Please, can you turn down the volume of your radio sets, please?
Okay.
All right.
You know the meaning of marriage.
Please, we would need you to turn down the volume of your radio set, or you try to call us back. 0816-251-9991. Please move away from your radio set if you want to speak with us. Hello, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Yes,
how are you?
Good afternoon. We are doing amazing. Thank you. Who is speaking with us?
My name is Olumide.
Where are you calling us from?
I'm calling from Ileoluchi.
Thank you very much for calling. Please go ahead.
Please, what I want to say is this. I agree with the one of the speakers who said adjust. Now, it's either you adjust, or if you find it extremely difficult to adjust, then you separate. I don't like separation, but that is why I like the why. If you cannot cope, if you cannot adjust, then they just say, okay, let's go our own different ways. I think it's better rather than killing ourselves and say by force we'll glue to ourselves and we'll end up killing ourselves. I can point to several marriages where they ended up killing themselves. So that's my contribution. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Lumide, for calling. I think that's going to be the last call we'll be taking on the program.
Okay, before we go?
Yes, like the last caller said, you should try to adjust. And then about the question you asked the other time, how can you identify? Now, when you do something that is not palatable to your spouse, he or she will talk, then you should take it for a no and then adjust.
And don't do it again.
Yes, don't
this person
do
doesn't like this person.
Even if it happens accidentally,
you know how to say sorry.
She will understand that this is not intentional.
Yeah.
Well, I think with commitment and diligence, you can fight your way to a successful marriage or relationship.
Okay. Professor? Before you say anything, I saw this quote online. It says, the happiest couples never have the same character. They just have the best understanding of their differences.
I just the point.
That's it.
At the beginning, I said, there can never be a carbon copy of you.
No way.
It's not possible. It's just a matter of understanding the person, like my friend said, adjusting. And then we have to be selfless too. We have to be selfless. We have to know that, let me bend a little bit here so that my partner can also
bend.
Enjoy his what he values and then go ahead to achieve his ideals.
I think it's also important before we go to marriage to let young people know that marriage is a lot of work.
It's a lot of work.
Don't enter into it with the, It's a lot of work.
But they shouldn't be scared of it.
No, they shouldn't be scared about it. At least we have stories of people who are into it and they're doing very well. Thank you very much, Professor Bolanle Ogunbamila, for coming on the program. We hope to have you again on the show.
Yes,
we hope so. All right.
We thank Kole too and Jumoke.
Thank you for coming on the show.
On that note, we draw the curtain on today's edition of Pain's Love and Family. My name is Dimeji Dines, and from Moni.
Thank you for joining us on today's edition. Next week will be another time. See you. Bye-bye.
Everybody's looking for that something. One thing that makes it all complete. You find it in the strangest places. Places you never knew it could be.
Some find it in the face of their children.
88.9 FM.